Hi, I'm Wade from Thoroughbred Diesel, and today we're going to teach you how to change out the cam position sensor on a 6.0 Powerstroke. Changing cam position sensor on a 6.0 Powerstroke is not a hard job at all. It's just a little bit difficult to get to the cam position sensor, but we're going to show you today how to get to it, how we do it. Try to make it just a little bit easier on you. We're using an Alliant Power cam position sensor. We have these on the website. This is an Alliant Power, part number AP63415. Now you can see the cam position sensors on these 6.0 Power Strokes are a little bit different than probably what you're normally used to if you guys are used to 7.3s or whatnot. A little bit different, it's quite a bit longer. It goes quite a bit, pretty good ways inside of the block there before it gets to the tone ring on the cam position sensor. It's got two O-rings on it. These two O-rings right here, they create this the seal to keep you from having oil leaks on this. Another thing with this is when you go to remove the cam position sensor, it's actually is the tension that you're going to feel, so trying to remove it. A single 8-metric headed bolt is what holds this in. Electrical connector on the top. It's kind of oriented into the block such as so, with the tab down like that. So we're gonna show you all that. You can totally do this job topside. Totally can do this job topside. Remove the air intake and that gets you just about where, that gets you where you need to be able to do it. When I remove the bolt on this, I remove it from the bottom. And I'm gonna show you that today. It's for me, it's just a little bit easier. When I'm working with a fastener, I always like to be in a line of sight of it so I can see is my socket engaged on it correctly so I don't round it off, because bolts and stuff like that that are in that position, you round them off and you're gonna have a heck of a time getting to them with an ease out or something of that nature to be able to get the bolt out. So I take one extra step. I actually pull the bolt out up from the bottom on these, and we're gonna show you that right now. All right, and I've got one more thing that I want to talk about removing the bolt from the cam position sensor. I use a 1/4-inch drive. I've got an 8-metric swivel socket that I use. You can use a shallow well 8-metric on a universal will be just fine for you. The angle of the cross member there on the bolt is just not going to let you go straight to it. If you got little hands, you can get a deep well on it and a 1/4-inch drive ratchet and get it. This is the best setup that I use. So an extension there, 1/4-inch drive extension and a swivel 8-metric socket really helps to be able to get to it. All right, we're at the front of the truck now, and I'm gonna go ahead and slide underneath the truck. I'm gonna try to take you with me, and I'm gonna show you where the cam position sensor is. Now, you can see that my light is positioned across the cross member here. What we were looking at right there is the power steering pump. That's what that is, that's got the pulley on the front of it. Your cam position sensor is right behind that. So I'm gonna take my light here and I'm gonna kind of point to this assembly. Power steering pump, right behind it is the cam position sensor. Now I've got a light on it. I should be able to see the bolt. I'm gonna try to zoom in just a little bit there. All right. You can see my light is now shining on the cam position sensor itself. And as I move the camera there, there is the 8-metric bolt for the cam position sensor. I've got my light on it right now. So as you can see, that's kind of a little bit of a tight fit. I wanted to be able to put a light on it and show you exactly where it was. We are on the driver's side of the engine. This is the power steering pump. Cam position sensor is directly behind it, right there where my light is. My light's actually looking at the wiring harness, going to the cam position sensor. So let me go ahead and reposition my camera here, and we'll show you how we set this tool up to be able to take the 8-metric bolt out of the cam position sensor. All right, we're gonna go ahead and move our socket and our extension in here and get on the head of the bolt. I know you can't see it there, but we kind of just wanted to let you see the path we take to get the tool in there. I do not unhook the electrical connector on the cam position sensor on the 6.0s. I just get the bolt out from here. My socket's got screwed up on me somehow. So over the power steering lines like this, and then right to the bolt itself. I can see it. I know I've got good engagement on it, so I'm gonna go ahead and break the bolt loose. And once you break it loose, you can usually get to it with your fingertips between those lines and just go ahead and back the bolt out. Or put a piece of paper in the socket, and that will keep the bolt in there for you so you don't lose the bolt. Usually don't have any problems with that. Usually will come right on out there. Just like so. Again, I leave the electrical connector on it. I will disengage the electrical connector once I have the cam position sensor out. Now we're topside. To get to the cam position sensor, to be able to get your arms down there to pull it out, you've got to pull the air intake box out. The air intake box on a 6.0 Powerstroke is the bane of my existence. I hate them. I hate getting them out. It doesn't matter how many times I've done it. I don't do it right every time. It's awful. This is terrible design, and that's enough of that rant. So first thing you want to make sure that you do, get your negative battery cables off, because you are going to be disconnecting your mass airflow sensor. You are going to be working with a cam position sensor, so better safe than sorry. Go ahead and knock your negative battery cables off. I'm going to go ahead and unplug my mass airflow sensor. Then I will unhook the filter restrictor or filter minder here. I pull the filter minder out of the box. It just gives me that much more clearance, 5/16. I loosen this up because I pull these by, I leave the front lid on. I found that to be the easiest. And I try to pull it out as a filter assembly with that back lid on the box. Might not be a good way to do it. I don't know. I just found that that's the best way for me. I go ahead and unhook my back cover. I disengage it from the filter, then work the filter back and forth, disengaging it from its pedestals. Once I can clear the back lid, it's usually all over but the crine. And just kind of twist it out. I'm sure there's easier ways to do that, but that's what I've found is the easiest for me. All right, with the air intake out, what we're going to do to get to the cam position sensor is we're actually just going to stick our arms down through here. All right, the wiring harness for the cam position sensor, I'm going to feel around and let it guide me to where the cam position sensor is. I've got my hands on it right now. I've left the wiring harness on it. I'm not pulling on the wiring harness. I'm pulling on the cam position sensor itself, but the wiring harness being on it just leaves it as a guide for me. So I kind of try to work it back and forth to get it broke loose from the initial hold that's in the block there, and then I just work it back and forth gently. Once I've got it disengaged from the block, I will go ahead and pull it on out just like this. And just continue to pull till it's clear of the block. Then take my wiring harness. Go ahead and take my wiring harness off from here. I can almost get it up to myself and disconnect the wiring harness. All right, now we're going to show you how to put the cam position sensor back in, and we're going to shoot this from the top side so you can kind of see from the top side what we did there. Not going to be a whole lot of good shots here. The GoPro shot that we got for you with the cam position sensor coming out kind of tells the story. But top side, go ahead and get your cam position sensor hooked up and your new Alliant Power cam position sensor, and go ahead and hook it up there. It is magnetic, so you'll have to watch it. All right, then we're just going to gently. Feed our sensor back down here. And then this is just a feeling game at this point. What I do is I'll get my wiring harness and my cam position down here and get it in position. Feel around on the block for the chamber in the block. Once I get it started, sorry about the time it took to get that. Once I get it started, just go ahead and push it in. And what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to try to get the cam position sensor flush with the block where it goes. Don't draw it up with a bolt. If you're having to draw it up with a bolt, it's wrong. So, all right, that should be it. Now, all that's left to do is get our bolt back in, put our air intake back on, battery cables back on, and we've got a successful installation. So that's putting a cam position sensor into a 6.0. I know these aren't very good video shots, but we wanted to show you location on it. We wanted to show you how we get to it and try to make the job just a little bit easier for you. You guys, if you don't, like me, I got small arms, bigger guys, can't get to that. You can take this air intake pipe off, the intercooler pipe off. You can actually take it off. You can take the battery tray out for the platform for the air intake. And those two things pretty much give you a straight shot down through here to where you can get your arms in here to work on it. But you're still gonna have to work between the lower radiator hose here. So yeah, 6.0 cam position sensor installation. Woo, it's a mouthful. Got a question about this or any other Alliant Power parts, please give us a call, and we always appreciate it if you like and subscribe to our channel. So thanks for watching.